Hi, this is Fran with Little Windows, and I'm going to show you how to make a multi-photo bracelet using a couple of different techniques. We're going to try doming and casting. For this video, you'll need your photographs cropped to size, some scissors. You'll also need a mold, and these two come from our small mold set. These are the perfect size for making little cast cubes for your wrist or a necklace. You can also use our doming tray, and I'll show you both techniques. You'll need Little Windows Brilliant Resin, mixing cups, a mixing wand, some paper towels or napkins, and a drill, either the mini hand drill or the Creative Power Drill. You'll also need to decide what kind of fining screw you're going to use. Head pins or jump rings or connectors, and just get those ready ahead of time. You'll need some pliers and some wire cutters as well. These photographs have been printed on our special Little Windows photo paper. This photo paper is waterproof, and it also makes a permanent bond with your inkjet inks, so you won't have any bleeding or running when you put your photograph into the liquid. On our website, the 1-inch square shape of cropper is free. This demonstrates one of our other cropper shapes that's available in our store. This particular one fits our small molds perfectly. All we need to do is cut these out. I've cut out these photos and now they're ready to be cast. For this one, where I've used Photoshop to shrink my images down, I'll use my cropping template that comes with the small mold set to trace and crop my images out. Since we're using the doming technique for this bracelet, you could actually make these any shape you like. If you prefer, you can also use scrapbook punches to punch out your images. Now it's time to mix the resin. I'll mix one small batch, and that will be enough for both bracelets. 10 milliliters of part A. Clean the neck of the bottle so that it doesn't get messy. And we'll add 5 milliliters of part B. And blend for 2.5 minutes. Stirring slowly, keep the point of your mixing wand on the bottom of the cup. I've stirred this for 2.5 minutes. Now we need to let it rest in the cup for 5 minutes. It'll continue to blend on a finer level, and any bubbles that you've mixed in will be able to rise to the top. It's been 5 minutes. The resin is ready to use. We're going to skim off any bubbles that are remaining on the top layer. You don't want to pour those into your projects, and then we're ready to go. Before you pour into the molds, make sure that the cavities are all very flat at the bottom. Sometimes they can curve up as they're stored or in shipping, so make sure those are all resting flat on your table. For these pieces, you want it to lay sort of flat on your wrist, so we're not going to make them very deep. I'll just squeeze my cup and pour a small amount into each of the cavities. So we're going to make the cast pieces first. I have a domed piece to do as well, but I'm doing the castings because these are the ones where it's so important for you to get the photograph into the mold as soon as you can, so that any bubbles can rise and pop before the resin starts to thicken. I'm taking the photographs and just sliding them halfway into the resin so that they are fully coated. If you had put your photographs in first and then put resin on top, you could get air pockets trapped underneath, which would not be smooth. It can also make your photograph dry, kind of wonky, and it can also make bubbles come up in your piece later down the road as it's curing. So I'm taking my mixing wand, I'm just going to push the photograph gently to the bottom of the mold, and the resin will come up over the top of each photo. You'll see bubbles in each one, you know, at least one or two. Don't worry about that though, because most of them will rise and pop on their own. So you want to do the least amount of work you need to here. We'll use our dust cover that comes with the molds to keep that protected as it's setting up, and we're ready to move on to our domed pieces. These pieces I've arranged on our silicone doming tray somewhat close together. You can spread them further apart if you'd like, but I wanted to make sure they would all fit underneath my one dust cover. So these are small pieces. Rather than pouring the resin on, I'm just going to take a scoop, touch my wand to the center of each photo, and let that resin run down. And since this is a nice smooth shape, the resin will flow beautifully and stop when it reaches the edge. Even after I've made my two bracelets, I still have some resin left over, so you can see how far the resin will go. I have another project I've been working on, and I'll just use that extra resin to fill in this dichroish piece. I'm doming on top of a cast piece here. It's been about 10 minutes, so let's check this for bubbles. Usually, if you're going to have any, they'll be around the edges. Sometimes you'll have a stubborn one that will stick to the photo itself. You can even spin your mold around so that you can check. Oops, here are a few hiding in this corner. And once you've done that, cover it up and check again in another 10 minutes. The dome pieces look great. I see just one bubble here that I can pick up with my mixing wand. Let's cover these again, and those are ready to set too. With the doming technique, you'll want to flip your pieces over and dome the backside too, so you have a nice smooth finish. And I've already done that with these pieces. So those are ready to go. I'll demonstrate a cast cubes bracelet using these images. Now these are black and white versions of the same ones from Liz's wedding. Think of this as an ice cube tray. So what you want to do is just twist each cavity side to side so that you can loosen the edges of your piece. You want to be gentle so that your molds last indefinitely. Once we've loosened the sides, we can tip this over and simply tap the back of each cavity, and your mold pieces should just drop right out. When you cast in the molds, you'll notice the resin tends to creep up the sides. This creates that frame of light that enhances each photo and makes it look like a little window. But if it's too high, and especially since we're going to have this on our wrist, sort of exposed, we want to trim those down a little bit. And you can either do that with a damp nail file, or I think it's cleaner and easier just to trim it with scissors. So I'm just going to go around each side and trim a bit off that top, and then do the same to the corners. Any sharp small scissors will work. These are all trimmed and ready to go. So now you need to figure out how big your bracelet should be. For my wrist, I'm just going to use this very fancy piece of paper wrapped around. And then you have to decide how loose you want your bracelet to be. I don't want this to be too loose with the cast pieces because we don't want them to flip over accidentally. So I'm going to want my bracelet to be about this long. I'm going to use these sterling silver head pins to connect these together. So the link is not going to be very large, but what I need to do is narrow this down to my very favorite pieces to include, because I know that they're not all going to fit. The next thing to do is drill my pieces. Before I do that, I'll take each piece, put it back into the cropping template, and this small arrow here will show where to drill the hole so that it hangs straight. That way, all of the holes will be lined up and even. You want to come in at least an eighth of an inch from the edge so that it doesn't tug through the side of the resin. For the domed piece, I'm going to use these little, very strong jump rings. So let's organize these. I want it to dangle a little bit more, and since these pieces are double-sided, I don't mind if it flips a bit. So I'm going to space this apart a little more. These are the pieces I've selected for my bracelet. And now we can start drilling. You'll want to protect your surface while you drill. I'm just going to use a block of wood. The mini hand drill comes assembled this way for protection. So you just want to open it up, flip it in, and then screw it back together, and you'll be ready to go. It swivels at the end, so you're going to be putting the pressure with your palm while you twist and drill through your piece. Your domed pieces are quite thin, so they're pretty easy to drill through. Again, come in at least an eighth of an inch from the side of your piece. Hold it firmly with your left hand while you twist your drill through. Twist the drill a few times in the hole to clean it out. You can use the mini hand drill on your cast pieces as well. Again, keep the drill bit straight up and down while you push with your palm. Twist with your fingers. And it will make a nice clean hole. You can also use a power drill like this creative drill. This one comes with 5 different sizes of drill bits. You're just going to place your piece, hold it firmly with your left hand if you're right-handed, turn this on, and drill straight up and down, going slowly. You don't need to push too hard. If you are doing a lot with bigger drill bits, you might want to wear a mask as well, because you don't want to be inhaling any kind of dust. These small holes are perfect for the findings that we're using. They fit right through there and it sits nicely in the hole. But if you find that your hole is too small, you can use your drill to ream it out just a little bit to enlarge that hole. Or of course you can use a larger drill bit on your power drill. For this cute bracelet, I'll do a simple wire wrap. I'll feed my head pin through from the front side. It hides that hole. I'll bend it, and then use my round nose pliers to make a nice smooth loop. Now you just need to decide how far apart you want these to be. I want them kind of close together, so I'll make my loop a little smaller. They would end up this distance if I did it the way they are now. So I'm just going to tighten up that loop a little bit. That looks right. So I have my flat pliers. I'll grab that and then wrap the tail of that head pin around the base at least 1.5 times to make a nice secure wrap. Trim off the extra. And I'll use my pliers to tuck that little cut end in so that it doesn't poke me while I'm wearing this. So now I'm going to attach the next one. This one will need to be a sideways loop to connect with this first one. So, again, I'll use my round nose pliers to make a loop to the side. So you see how that one's different than the first one. Loops out to the side instead of up and down. So now I will go ahead, feed these through together so they're linked, and then wrap that wire around. Pinch it a little bit so that the stems are closer together. And I'm just going to hold that while I wrap the wire around the base. And then again toward the front. So that's gone around 1.5 times. You can go ahead and snip off the extra. And pinch that end down. coming in tighter on this one, just in case. Hopefully it'll help you get a better view. Bend it up. Again, this is the one that we're wrapping up and down. We'll make that loop just a little bigger to match the other ones. Wrap the wire. And pull it tighter with another pair of pliers. Snip the end. And tuck that in. Now you can either wrap this clasp directly onto your last loop, or what I'm going to do is give myself a little bit more space to attach that and add a jump ring here. This piece has a nice snug fit that's not going to flip over while I'm wearing it. But if you'd like, you can also add another ring or two just to give you a little bit more space. And this is the same piece that we made using spacer beads in between. The pearls add a really nice touch to these wedding photos. The domed bracelet we're going to put together with jump rings. These are some nice, strong, thick sterling silver ones. And they need to be opened up so that you can pinch them through the hole on each end. So usually jump rings come a little bit twisted. We're going to straighten that out. Open the jump ring so that it's wide enough for your domed piece to fit inside, and then feed it through the holes, top and bottom. Make sure it's lined up, and then squeeze it. Now we'll use the same jump rings as spacers to attach these pieces together. Twist it open. Add your pieces. Twist it closed. Let the ends brush together so that it hides the seam. For the end piece, you can hook them directly into the last link. This bracelet is finished. I really like the look and the feel of the domed bracelets as well. This is now waterproof and quite durable. For more great project ideas and quality products, visit little-windows.com.